Well, we are now, I believe, in our 10th session of the series on the gospel and the harvest, and we look at one of the great ideas, in my judgment, in the entirety of the Bible. Every morning, I wake up and I get myself ready for the day, and one of the things that I do before I leave is I put in a jewel in my ear, some kind. Some sort of earring. It's a reminder to me of my son, Matt, our son, who died so soon ago, but who was dear to us, and I use it as a thing of remembrance. I've always said I'm going to upgrade my earpieces, like to real diamond. And I was thinking just the other day, what is the world's most famous jewel? Do you know? There are a number of diamonds in the running, a number of jewels that you could legitimately claim are the world's most famous diamond. But there's no diamond like the Hope Diamond. It's one of the great, it's an amazing, it's really one of the most famous jewels in the world. It's big as nearly as a walnut, a pigeon's egg. It's got this particular tint. This much admired blue color comes from trace amounts of boron atoms. It weighs about 45 carats, which for diamond weight is amazing. It's nearly an ounce. It's a third of an ounce. It's an exceptional size. I mean, and it glows red, you know, when you're just looking at it at different angles. It's just an amazing thing. It's been compared in size to a walnut or pigeon egg. It's really an amazing thing. It's insured, the Hope Diamond, for $250 million. A quarter of $1 billion for a single diamond. It is, in some respects, one of the most spectacular things that has ever been found. It's centuries. It has had a number of centuries in its, knowledge of it and whatever. There is a text that is essentially, Max Lucado called it the Hope Diamond of the Bible. The most important text in Scripture. It's John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. This is what Max Lucado said. He said, this verse, John 3:16, he wrote a whole book on it. It's the Hope Diamond of the Bible, a 26-word parade of hope, beginning with God, ending with life, and urging us to do the same. Brief enough to write on a napkin or memorize it in a moment, yet solid enough to weather 2,000 years of storms and questions. If you know nothing of the Bible, he says, start here. If you know everything about the Bible, return here. We all need the reminder, the heart of the human problem is the heart of the human. And God's treatment is prescribed in John 3:16. He loves, he gave, we believe, we live. The gospel declares God's matchless love for humankind, revealed in the gift of his one and only son. Now, as per usual, we're gonna go through John 3:14 through 21, answering these questions. What do we see? What do the facts mean? What gospel implications are there, and how do we actualize this? The text reads, and as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send a son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment. The light has come into the world, and people love the darkness rather than the light, because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light and does not come to the light, lest his work should be exposed. But whoever does what is true comes to the light, so that it may be clearly seen that his works have been carried out in God. What an amazing text. Now, what do we see here? Well, Jesus is the antitype of the bronze servant in the wilderness. This is spoken of in Numbers 21. There was a plague that went among the people, and all they had to do, God told them to make a bronze serpent, put it on a pole, hold it up above the people, and whoever looked at the serpent on the pole would be saved. Jesus said, in the same way that bronze serpent was hoisted, so I am going to be lifted up, and life will come to me. Then in John 3:16, we have these two amazing ideas. He shows his love by giving us his son, and all humankind has to do is believe. His love prompted him to give his son. And our understanding of that love should prompt us to believe. And then in verses 19 through 21, Jesus said the condemnation is that people simply won't come to the light. They would rather walk in darkness than to be saved. Now, what do these facts mean? It means that God's love is the impulse behind salvation. In Christ, Jesus had to die to redeem us. His love, God's love, was shown through the sacrifice of his son on our behalf. And faith in him is the only way to receive this life. To look to him as they look to the serpent is life, and to spurn him is death. Now, what is the gospel implication for this? And this is it for me. The motive, the heart of salvation for humankind is the love of God the Father, shown, revealed in the sacrifice of his son. So how do we actualize this? How do we make this love our own? All we have to do is receive God's offer of love. Guys, it's that simple, that clean, that easy, that profound. All he asks is that you receive this love. It's an amazing idea that through faith in the gospel of Christ, we receive God's love. We acknowledge that God loved us that much. We receive the gift of his son. We believe in him, clinging by faith to him, and we accept this life that will never, ever perish for those who understand that love. I like what C.S. Lewis said about the unchanging heart of God, this love. He said, though our feelings come and go, God's love for us does not. That's a simple sentence, but it captures the very core of this unbroken, unfailing, faithful love of God revealed in the sacrifice of his son. The gospel declares God's matchless love for humankind revealed in the gift of his one and only son for us all. So the next time you think of the love of God, maybe you can think of this exquisite diamond, $250 million for a single diamond. This text, God's love for humankind, is the hope diamond of Scripture, and it's the hope of everyone who clings to Christ in faith. Amen.